Hey guys, I'm Cam, and today I wanted to post a short video to let you know how I got on with the Aegismax sleeping bag. So some of you may remember that I did a review of the Aegismax sleeping bag when I first ordered it, and I sort of went over all the specs and what I liked about it on paper, and I tested it just sort of in my living room, but now I have used it a few times on some long distance trips, so I wanted to report back. So first, I used that sleeping bag on the Cowellway back in mid-March when the temperatures were still very cold, and now more recently I have used it on the Speyside Way and different trails in Speyside and the Cairngorms. Because that sleeping bag is rated at a comfort temperature of 6 degrees Celsius, I chose to be safe and order a sleeping bag liner made by Sea-to Summit. And I have used it on those two trips, and I have found that the two combined have made for a really good sleeping system and have kept me warm even at -3 or -4. So I will put a link down below for the Sea-to Summit liner, but for the weight that it weighs, I found that it's really worth it and that it does add quite a lot of degrees to your sleeping system. So I have yet to test the sleeping bag without a liner, but what I can say of it other than the temperature is that it's amazingly compact. It takes a few times to practice and to put it back into the stuff sack, but once you've found the technique, which is really to sort of from the very beginning really push the material down to the very bottom of the stuff sack as you go and kind of put your hand flat so that you use all the space within the stuff sack to make the sleeping bag fit, then it does get super compact. I also really like the dimensions. I didn't feel tight in it at any point, and it was long enough, and also if it was really cold I could put the hood on and really tighten up the whole sort of area around the face to be really cozy in it, making sure to never breathe within it so that I didn't put any humidity within it. I have noticed that some feathers are coming out of it. Maybe in the morning I would find, like, you know, maybe 3 or 4 feathers flying around every morning. So I'm hoping that doesn't keep on happening. Perhaps this is something that is quite common for down sleeping bags. So I'm not quite worried about it yet. If it keeps on happening and then the bag on the long term becomes slimmer, then I'll start worrying. So for now, I'm very happy with this sleeping bag. I will keep it until I can afford to buy a sleeping bag that is a better quality and also at a higher comfort temperature. I've actually got my eye on a Katabatic Gear sleeping bag, but that's much more expensive. I think that retails at around £350, so that's not something I can afford just yet. So I think that's as much as I want to say about it for now. As you can tell, I'm really happy with it overall. I wanted to keep this video short, and if you have any questions, please feel free to comment down below. And thank you very much for watching. Please subscribe if you haven't already done so, and I'll see you on the next one.